Welcome back to my channel. Doing a video today on the Survivor Series 2020. I was able to, even though I'm in quarantine, I was able to watch it through, you know, Amazon Stick. Shout out to Amazon Stick, you know, that type of thing. And let's get the elephant out the elephant in the room out the way. Yeah, I got my Raiders hat on. We lost, but hey, we competed. It's still Raiders all day. So let's get into the Survivor Series, man. So, first match I saw was the men's match. They did Raw versus SmackDown, pretty much a team of five. And I don't think they had like the best five people. I just think they just kind of put, I don't know, mixture together or something like that. But I don't know how I like the result, because what it ended up being is they're trying to push Jey Uso into, you know, a mix, kind of with the Roman Reigns story, but. They had him as like the last person available on SmackDown, and they made it seem like their team was dysfunctional, so it don't make it seem like SmackDown actually just sucks. But Raw ended up like winning by just a clean sweep. That like they eliminated everybody on SmackDown, and it was kind of like okay, we get the storyline with the Uso and Roman Reigns and all stuff, but it kind of, I don't know, for somebody that's trying to keep your brand up, it didn't really, I don't know, it wasn't really good for SmackDown, if you ask me. But either way, so I might be skipping around matches here, but we had the women's match. So the storyline behind this is kind of trying to get some of those women, the women wrestlers that's not been in the spotlight or need to be in the spotlight, and then you have some that's been in there before. But you got the main ones: Becky Lynch pregnant, Charlotte Flair pregnant, they're gone. So it's like, who's gonna step up, who's gonna be next? Let's see how the crowd reacts. And you know, they had a few in there, like, you know, Lacey Evans, Peyton Royce, you know, what's Nia Jax, I'm trying to, and then her tag team partner. You know, you have a lot of front runners in there, but it was like, I'll say this, good pay-per-view overall. That match, the female match, it was a couple of botches in there, with Natalya Hart, a couple of botches in there, regardless, but it was a good match. The theme behind it was Lana was getting put through tables by Nia Jax all the time, and like nine times total. And she made the team, whether she got lucky or not, but she made the team, and they pretty much made her sit on the like the ring stairs. So it was kind of like she was just sitting there, kind of like a battle royal or a Royal Rumble where you forget somebody's in the match because they've been like outside hurting for the whole time, and then when it's toward the end, they come back in and eliminate you, and they won. That's pretty much how she won. So everybody got eliminated at the end of the day, and she was the last one remaining because she didn't really participate in the second half of the match. But it was a decent match. It was a decent pay-per-view overall, I will say that. The part I went and go took a shower on was because it was late, but it was the IC Championship versus the US Championship. What was it? The Hurt Business dude. I can't even remember his name. That's so bad. And then the Intercontinental Championship from SmackDown. They went at it. He lost by trying to cheat. It was corny. It was hella corny. And I like the Hurt Business. It's a little cool little faction that the WWE is putting together, and they kind of just make them, I mean, look relevant in that thing. The thing I didn't notice about Survivor Series, I didn't see the pre-show, but I didn't know if the Retribution got involved in. I don't know what their deal is, like what place they play in the company and all that type of stuff. But anyway, moving on. So you had the tag team championships. I missed that match. So it's kind of like a passing of the guard, like New Day versus the Street Profits. And man, first of all, what a promo cut by the Street Profits before that. That was, they paid homage to a couple of people, and it was just like, it was lit. They came in the match, they had a good match, and they delivered it. And at the end of the day, they shook their hand. It was almost, the New Day is not gone, but it's almost like shaking their hands, like we're passing the torch to y'all, you know. But it was wild. And the New Day got their little promo in before, you know, they're gonna be a part of a video game or be an option for a video game. So, you know, they're making that money. But hey, hella tight tag team match. Then you had the the heavyweight match versus the heavyweight match. So Universal versus the WWE champion Roman Reigns versus Drew McIntyre. And for them not to know, like, well, Drew McIntyre, he has his set moves or whatever. Roman Reigns, same thing. But you know, the knock on him is he can't wrestle. And it's low key true. But since he came back, he's been in pretty good shape, and he's been putting on a kind of show. And that was a match. That was a match. So you had the tag team match was a match. The female Survivor Series traditional match was a match. The New Day versus, well, I said that already. Roman Reigns versus Drew McIntyre was a good match. It ended up in McIntyre kind of jobbing for Roman Reigns, but you know, he's the face of the company, but ran into the ref type thing and blah blah blah. You know, Jay Uso came down and now they reunited as a family and blah blah blah. But it up until then, the match was like head to head, man. It was pretty dope. I wonder how they're gonna kind of refurbish that, like how they're gonna push forward with that. I mean, you didn't see any Bray Wyatt appearance or anything like that, at least from when I saw it. But the dopest part of Survivor Series was the farewell to Undertaker. Man, salute Undertaker, salute. You know, like I've been a wrestling fan for a long time, and I'm just, you know, kind of, I watch it, but you know, I'm not like, ooh, I gotta see, but I watch it, you know, like I watch football, basketball, whatever, same thing. But as a kid, you know, I was a real fan, and the Undertaker, he's been there throughout. He's been there as Mark Calloway came to the WWE, WWF back then, as the Undertaker broke character, like, hands down. Like, you can say, oh, Rock is the best wrestler, Stone Cold, Ric Flair, Hulk Hogan, whatever. But career-wise, you are not messing with that dude. Like, longevity, man. Longevity, 30 years, like, wow, he keeps coming back. He keeps on, you know, he reinvented himself, and he had a couple of characters like along the way with the Undertaker thing, and they all hit, they all work, you know what I mean? But they had like a good farewell for him. It's like one like final, like he come down to the ring, get that feeling. It was like bone chilling and stuff, you know. It was dope, man. He had a lot of people, I guess, that was available for WWE to come down, you know. Be in the ring, Nature Boy, Booker T, Savio Vega, the Godwins, random Big Show, Kevin Nash. It was a lot of like a ring full of people. Shawn Michaels, I'm probably missing some, but ring full of people for him, and it was cool. They all left when he came down. Kane came down in the wrestling gear. It was dope, man. Like, farewell to the Undertaker. I know, just watching his specials, he'll be back in some way or some form. Vince gonna call him back, but it may not be to the impact of, like, WrestleMania or anything like that, like wrestling on a big stage to stay undefeated and all that. But good show. Vince, a lot of people saying Vince looks bad, man. I don't know how old he is, but I know the dude is in the 70s or 80s, and he looks pretty good. For me, but he probably was a little emotional, and you know, with COVID, you know, he's been staying indoors and stuff. Like, dude might be a little pale or something, but I can see what people are saying, but it was people saying that they're going around like they're wondering about his health and all that, but he definitely came out for Undertaker and just probably so, man. I mean, that dude made him a lot of money and stuff, so of course, and even other wrestlers did, but Undertaker, man, that was his ace boom, so it still is, you know. So anyway, that's Survivor Series to me and a little rap. Jumped on this channel, doing this video. I'm gonna edit it up, post it. I'm a little late. I apologize for that, man. I trying on this new channel, and y'all subscribe if y'all can, man. I'll put the link in the description, or yeah, there you go. Yeah, man. I put a reaction up, and I was trying something new, and like I said, man, YouTube strike me. They didn't strike me. They just says copyrighted, can't do it. We blocked it already. Boom. So wasted all the editing time and all that stuff just for them to, while I'm uploading it, say no go. But we gonna get it. We gonna get it right. Until then, man, y'all be safe. Take care of each other, and see y'all on the next one.